Welcome to Tokyo, where ancient tradition lives on amongst 21st century bustle. It's the 43rd Artistic Gymnastics World Championships. Tokyo Tower dominates the skyline, but it's the superb gymnastic performances that will be the focus of attention. The city of 13 million people and its beautiful night skyline set the backdrop for a thrilling competition. Today we'll be treated to the first two of four women's individual apparatus finals. Lots in store for us. And the eight that have won through from qualifying to begin this day of finals with vault. Michaela Maroney from the USA has to start favorite. Superb. But here we have Alex Moreno Medina from Mexico. She qualified in sixth place, 17 years old. First vault. 1.5 twists, but she took it slightly to the side. Two vaults required in the final. Have to be different, and the average is taken. Look at the effort. Eyes focusing hard on the plant of the hands. 1.5, just a little bit deep on the landing. First vault, 14.733 from a difficulty of 6.3. Second vault has to be different. Power in the run. Sugihara full twist in a nice straight body position. Not as difficult as the first, 5.2, so she's going to try and really focus on style. Very nice, clean leg shape in the air. Just a little bit deep on the landing. There you can see the average, 14.216, 13.7 for the second vault. So that will be the target. Jade Fernandez Barbosa. Has she qualified? In fourth place, and that's a nice clean vault to start with. Very clean indeed. She was third last year in the World Championships on this apparatus, and that's a good start, double twist. Very good lift, bolts upwards, pulls the arms in hard to the hips to make the twist. Double twist. 14.866. That's a good opener. And look at the execution score. 9.066. So, we have Alexa Moreno Medina. She has the target. And this young lady's already surpassed it on the first vault. But it's the average of two, so she can't slip up on this one. Big attacking run, half on. Ooh, that looked nasty. She landed okay, but look at her face. She's cringing with pain. She just took a step back. Let's have a look at this now. Lovely in the air, and she really did wrap. Ooh, the instep underneath. That's a ligament job, and look at the pain. 14.566, the average. She's in the lead, but she's very, very uncomfortable with that. What a pity. The Than Phan from Vietnam, and what an achievement to get into this final. She qualified in eighth place, 14.216. That's an achievement in itself now. What can she produce? Obosa out in front at the moment. Nice one and a half twisting handspring front somersault. So that's a very good start for her. Pushing hard to increase the difficulty. 14.6, 8.7 execution. Needs to step it up. Van Fan. Nice little skip at the start. Now she's into the rhythm. Good preparation. Double twist. Now she's up the difficulty there. She did a full twist to qualify. And here she is with a double twist, making her bid. Good pop up from the top of the horse. Nice and clean in flight. Just about got it round. Let's have a close look. She has to get the hips and shoulders all the way round to get it to count as a double twist. She's made it. 14.733, 14.6, 14.666 is the average, and she's gone into the lead. Vietnam in a medal position. What an achievement. Tatiana Navieva. She qualified in seventh place, and the target for her, Marina Medina at the moment in third, then Fernandez Barbosa. Oh, and that's a good strong vault to open. But we need a closer look because she does tend to lose form in the air, Nabaeva. You can see she cast to the side a little there. And the legs, you'll see now, quite buckled. And that's quite a deduction. Vietnam's Thi Thanh Phan is out in front at this stage. So the first vault, 14.566, and she needs an average of 14.666. So she really needs to step up the difficulty here. Vietnam in one, Brazil two, Mexico three. Fabulous, the spread of nations in this final. Look at the aggression here. Nabaeva made the half twist, but it's not the most difficult of vaults, and you can see in her face, she doesn't really think she can challenge with that. It's a 5-2 difficulty. Flip, half turn on from the Yurchenko approach and front somersault half off. Now, can she get into third above the Mexican? This is a feature of this vault final. We've got Vietnam in one, Brazil in two, Mexico in three. That's the spread of nations. She's gone into third, so a medal position at the moment, but 14.349 as an average leaves the door wide open for this young lady, Michaela Moroni, who really has set new standards. She's high, she's clean, and she's very, very difficult. Look at the approach. Superb, very high, very clean in the 2.5 twists. Rest of her teammates really get into the spirit of this competition. Just look at that and the line. She got 2 feet either side of the line, then just had a tiny adjustment from it, but that's lovely work. But you've got to do it twice. Look at this, 9.3 execution. 6-5 difficulty, 15.8 the score. But the second vault has got to be consistent. It's got to be solid. Same bustling approach. Hits hard, half turn on, nice and high and clean coming off. That surely will give her the lead. Look at the lovely body line. She's raised the bar in terms of quality vaulting amongst the women. Perfect extension through the legs and ankles. Superb work. Second vault, 14.8. That's 15.3 the average in first.
Next, Julia Steinhuber, representing Switzerland.
and a reputation for good, strong vaulting in Switzerland, Juliet Steingruber. And she is a very powerful vaulter indeed. 1.5 twists from the handspring pike front somersault. A very good opening bid. She is European quality on this event. And we have to remember Keislin, her teammate, who also was a superb vaulter. 14.9 for the opener. So she's on course with a 6-3 difficulty. The second one now. Plenty of attack. Good contact. Just the full twist, if you can say such a thing, but it was clean and high. If only she could step up the difficulty of the second vault. You can see the full twist. Half and half, very cleanly performed. 14 for the second, 14.45, fourth place. And it won't be a medal for Julia Steingruber from Switzerland. What can you say? Oksana Shusevitina won her first gold medal at the World Championships when the rest of this field in this vault final weren't even born. So that is unbelievable. And she's still here. She's still a contender. And look at that. 1.5 twist. No nonsense. What an advertisement she is for the sport. Look at the attack. 1.5 turns. She hardly moved to the side. Beautiful vault. 6.3 difficulty. 15.066. Now then, she'd love a medal. She'd love it to be gold, but it has to be around a 15.6. Can she do it? Oh, it's clean. It's a 1.5 twist that she opted to do. So the tariff will keep her down, but she performed it well. This is a medal vault. Question is, what color? 1.5 twists, dead center once again. She really is a phenomenon in women's gymnastics. Super. Now, has she got another medal? She has. 14.733. She goes on and on. Tremendous. Michaela Moroni, superb vaulter, takes the gold with an average of 15.3. Gold to the USA. Michaela Moroni, Oksana Shusevitina takes silver, and Than Phan takes a bronze for Vietnam. Superb. What a final. Great to see these nations involved at this level. In the USA, what a world championship they've had. Team champions, all-round victors, now the first of the individual apparatus. Oksana Shusevitina takes silver, and Than Phan takes the bronze. Great final. Another golden performance for the USA. Smiles all round. Shusevitina there again. So the second of the two women's finals today. It's the thrilling apparatus, uneven bars. Victoria Komova, highest qualifier. Coco Surumi will be out to lay the ghost of the problem she's had. She qualified well, then had problems in the team. But first up is Gabrielle Douglas, 15 years old. Part of the winning team, of course, for the USA. Nice. Full turn from the stoop. Oh, she clipped the bar there. Not disturbed the rhythm of the routine, though. She's continuing. This is going to be deducted, but she's not letting it disturb her focus. This is very good work. Look at the lovely line. Nice in the invert swing. Little bit short on handstand, but she's got it back there. very sharply and smartly into the full twisting double to finish. So she qualified in sixth. Full turn from the start there. That's the endo. Half turn, a little bit deep coming out. And very sharply into the full twisting double. So she opens this bars final with a 14.2. Gabrielle Douglas. That face last night was tearful. Victoria Komova, who everyone thought would win the all-around, but she had to be happy with second in the end. But this is a lovely start. Top qualifier she was on uneven bars. And look at the line. She's pencil straight. Beautiful. Shaposhnikova for half turn, keeping the swing. Pure in the handstand. Straight in the Jaeger, and that is a cracking skill. A little bit late on that turn, but the combination into Katya. Winding up. Now then. Full twist in the double, tiny adjustment. And is Victoria Komova back to winning ways? The 16-year-old youth Olympic champion. This is the half turn transfer to top bar, keeping the swing. She really is an elegant swinging gymnast in the classical Russian mold. And it's good to see her back in focus. She qualified with 15.733, and that's 15.5, the lead at the moment. And Japan have made such strides on uneven bars. She qualified in eighth, Asuka Teramoto, with 14.683. The vigilant coach underneath there, just in case of mishap. Full turn's okay. The Ginger facing the low bar really is amazing. Gives an indication of how tiny she is. Lovely in the Jaeger. Oh, but very short on that handstand, and the judges are very keen on that. Transfers through the pack to the low bar. Big double tuck to finish, and she certainly has made the most of her opportunity in this final. Qualified in eighth, and there are teammates supporting, of course. The coach wasn't needy, but he was there just in case. Lovely, clean, nice double tuck to finish. But there was an occasion when she missed a handstand. 7.9 for execution, 14.2. Second place behind Komova at the moment. Koko Tsurumi, 19 years old. Second on A-bars in 2009 at the London Worlds. She qualified in third, but she had a torrid time in the team and fell off the apparatus. She'll want to put it right. This is important. Lovely little flourish. Safely through the catch-up. Now she can go. There's the invert swing, lovely little flourish. She'll try it again the other way, and she nearly lost it. Lots of courage there. She picked up with the Jaeger. How she did that, I do not know. Really working hard now. And can she make the dismount? It's a double layout. Super, well done, Koko Tsurumi. There'll be a little smile. They enjoyed it, and so did she. There were errors, of course, but she's just proved to herself that she can do difficult work under pressure. Now you can see she almost didn't get the body round and had to struggle to get the line back. But she carried on. There's the connection into Jaeger. And a lovely double layout to finish. 14.066, so it was expensive, but she went through. That was the object of the exercise. Wang Guixiang, fourth in the all-round competition in 2010. Here she is, qualified in fourth on bars. Lovely. Very secure in the inverted swings. Very secure in the handstands. Nice in the Jaeger. A little bit loose-legged, tiny bit loose-legged in the Pak Salto to the lower bar. Very clean in the handstand. Full turn. Oh, and a double layout. She had to adjust once she'd landed, but she got her feet firmly planted on the deck and then had to make a small adjustment. But they really understand how to work from invert. That's a release from invert. And look at the double layout. Struggled to keep it under control, but she won the battle. Come over, appreciating that. 14.833, gone into second. So it's come over. Wang Guixiang. And Teramoto still there. Jordan Weber from the USA, the all-round champion, crowned just a couple of days ago. That forward circle is very difficult. She bent her arms out of it there on two occasions. Very, very difficult skill. Oh, and just dropped her feet a bit on the turn. But it really is a business-like, quick, sharp, brisk performance. Full turn. Toe on, into the catcher, nice and snappy. Big wind up. Nice double layout. And Jordan Weber. Those forward hip circles are so difficult. Bending her arms just a little, and you could see she was around the side, but she was working so fast. You wonder whether the judges picked up every error. We'll soon see. 14.5, she's gone into third. Execution 8-2, so the judges were hot. She was 6 on vault. Just an hour or so ago, Tatiana Navieva, 16 years old. Good start. Look at that. Clean in the handstand. Toe on. Full turn. Nice combination into half turn. Swinging well. Lovely half turn. This will be the Jaeger. Catches it clean. Lovely leg form here. We saw on vault she was loose-legged, but that was the first indication there, just a loss of leg form. But she's delighted with that routine. The smile's there, and it wasn't on vault. She knows she's done a good job there. Toe on. Into the Shaposhnikova. And there, the pack immediately into Stauder with full turn. This is good connected work. And then the half turn to the high bar. And Navieva's really working. Look at the grit and determination on her face. Full twisting double. And the smile will come pretty soon. There it is. Come over, watching and appreciating. Gone into second. 15 is the score. Terrific for Russia on bars. little tear of joy there. She's happy now. Confirmation. 1 and 2 for Russia. Gold and silver to them. Huang Quixiang takes bronze. Jordan Weber takes fourth place. Good final. Victoria Komova accepts the gold medal and smiles on Tatiana Nabeeva. She takes silver, 1 and 2 for Russia, and Huang Quixiang for China takes the bronze. Two more women's, three more men's finals still to come.